What is up, guys? It is me, Heidi, and I am here with one of my favorite people, and I think one of your favorite people, too.
Hi, guys.
Hi, guys.
If you don't recognize her, you need to get in the app, and you need to try our new dance program.
We got you. What are you waiting for? You're late.
I know. You are late. I think she's already dancing. To Epic Weekend, which
that
if you
was
don't know what
so
Epic Weekend
fun.
Is, you
that
need to
so
get
fun.
With it and you need to see what it is.
I
look right there.
I got you.
She's really
everyone
good at dancing,
at home.
But she's not good at knowing where to look.
I need someone to tell me. I obey orders. I see you. I
Nick,
see you.
Can we look at ourselves?
Your phone's on too.
Oh.
We're fine, guys. We were talking about Epic Weekend and how amazing it was. Like, I'm telling you, guys,
so
she was like
fun.
J-Lo.
Oh, well, they made me out to be
she
that.
Had glasses
I was like,
on, you had a hood on.
Oversized hoodie, and I snuck in for sound check.
True. True story.
All the hair was in a hoodie.
It was like kind of diva.
It was. I liked it.
But,
it felt amazing.
Like, what was it like to walk out on stage
when you
and
guys were at
everybody
there?
Like cheer for you?
That
it
was
so
unexpected. Honestly, unexpected, but made me feel like a million bucks. It
well,
really did. It was so fun.
Everybody watching right now like knows. Like you are a big deal in the Transform community, and it's not just because you're a great dancer. But because you're in that community, you're taking part.
Oh,
you're helping
I love
people
it.
Out.
So inspiring.
You
it
can.
Really is. Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
I got a heart.
Aww.
I got a heart.
She does have a heart, and that's why we love her. And we also love her hair.
Well,
which
it's looking
real.
A little ragged. We've been dancing like 100 hours today.
It's
so.
Real, though.
I love it.
Mine's
you always
fake.
Say that. It's
that's
real.
Mine's
it
fake.
Is. It grows right out.
Right
my
out of
head.
My head like a chia pet.
Yes.
I wish I had it. Okay, so you guys, today we wanted to talk about a few things. Well, very first thing, I want to talk to you guys. I want to share with you a couple testimonials that we've read. And I don't know.
Those are really cool.
I know you were telling me about one today.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
one
I
of them
it.
That I came across, I love. Somebody says, OMG, I'm liking this dance so much. I didn't even know my hips moved like this anymore.
I know that feeling.
Yeah.
I really do. I want to tell you. Oh, yeah.
You know
I
the
know
feeling of
feeling.
Not knowing
yes.
that your hips move?
100%. Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Well,
you
this person
finish?
Says,
yeah.
I'm done with one complete week and halfway into my second week. And this is big.
Yeah.
I lost 9 pounds, is
that
what
is
they said.
Crazy.
Say what? And some, and she lost some inches. So she says, I love the tone and pumps so much.
Yeah.
Which we're, I
yeah.
You filming those?
Yep,
what a
that.
Terrific idea to involve dance. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And that's just
so
one.
Cool. I was gonna say that is a very common thing that you hear, not feeling like your hips can move anymore, because I was there when I first started teaching. I was stiff as a board.
Really?
Oh my gosh. Stiff.
I can't imagine.
If
I
could
her.
Show you some footage, you would laugh so hard. I didn't know how to engage and let
really?
Loose like that.
Like me.
Yeah, well no, you can do it, girl. You can do it. But I couldn't, and part of it was a mental thing too, like
yeah.
allowing myself to do that.
Yeah.
But I look back at those videos and it's unrecognizable, it really is. So over time, you'd be surprised
so
what
you
your body can do.
So when you allowing yourself to do that, do you mean
yeah.
like you just felt silly? Because I know a lot
oh,
of people
for sure.
watching are scared to try the dance program,
yeah.
and I've seen that comment. They're scared to try it because they don't want to look stupid.
Yeah.
Do you want to talk on that?
And
for
that's
a second?
That's exactly kind of how I was feeling. I get a lot of feedback from other people on that same feeling, and it's just you just feel embarrassed. You know, you feel embarrassed, and you feel like, oh, I'm not moving like them,
zone.
And out of your comfort
yep.
zone, and I don't look like them, and so therefore I'm not going to do it.
Yeah.
And that's the thing that's so awesome about the app is it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
You can do it in your home. You can. Move like you move. You don't have to move like I move, but you're moving, and that's the best part of it. But that mental thing of just like letting go, nobody cares, nobody's judging you, and just let loose. And whatever that looks like, I think
like,
is awesome.
The saying, dance like nobody is watching, is actually something
yeah.
you can do because nobody is watching, and it feels like somebody is.
That's right.
Emily, Lindsay,
we're
Heidi,
staring
right
at you.
There.
We're staring at you through the screen, but.
And I'm like one page over.
Yes,
so we're all
exactly.
right there.
That's
but
right.
it is really cool. You can do this. And I think
yeah.
one of my favorite things about going into the community is seeing people that are brave enough, number one, to try it in their home. Like, that's a hard thing.
It's
hard for me to pull up your guys' dance videos and try them.
Yeah.
But when I get into it, it's like, oh my gosh, it's so much fun. But then people are posting the videos. Like, they're seeing, they have the courage, and they're overcoming.
Which then inspires other people to do it,
yes.
Which is super cool,
yes.
too. I know.
And then another thing that I'm loving is seeing all of these parents that are dancing and allowing their kids to join, so it becomes this family fitness movement.
Oh, I've gotten several messages like that where they're just like, my toddlers are going crazy at my feet, but that allows moms that are stuck at home that don't get to get out and dance or get out and even go to the gym, and now they can get their workout in as well as feeling like they're at a dance party, and now their kids can be going crazy around them, getting them moving, so it's a win-win for everybody.
Well, if you don't follow her on Instagram, you need to, because she
be my friend.
Posts videos all the time. Her kids are always like grooving.
That
and
is,
dancing.
It's so that's my cute. Favorite entertainment. Honestly, I had my husband get me a Google Home for Christmas last year. Intentionally put it in my kitchen so we can push play on music, and then that just gets the family to dance.
Does it?
And so now you can just sync up the dance with me, dance party, and it gets people dancing.
Which is a question people have. So you just said the word sync, which reminds me, people saying, it's hard for me to watch them dance on the iPhone. Or
the 2-inch version of me.
And actually follow.
Yeah.
So you should know you can actually stream it to an Apple TV. You were telling us about some apps that people can use to do it.
Yeah. Because if you have Chromecast, is that how it's said?
Is it Comcast?
No, Comcast is a different, that's like a server. This is a Chromecast, a thing you can buy. It's like an adapter type of thing.
Okay.
And then there's Roku or Roku, I'm not positive.
Okay.
Both of these things that you can buy, which allows, if you don't have like an updated smart TV or whatever,
it
allows you, or you have a smart TV but it's outdated, it allows you to get that app and then you sync it to your phone, to your television.
Gotcha. So. Okay. Heard it. You heard
the fact that I know that is mind blowing.
And you said that sometimes there's a slight delay with some apps, and it's not the app. It's the connection. So know if there's a slight delay in it.
And if you mean what she means by delay is like the music and the movement, we are right in the money.
She's
on. We are right on beat.
She's on.
I want you to know. But if we seem a little out of whack with the music, that's your connection.
Yeah.
And some people don't have that problem.
Basically, it's not her problem.
It's not my problem. It's not your problem. It's your problem. But I just, you know, I hope that that isn't like the most common problem, because that would drive me. I've asked a lot of people and they're like, actually I'm right on. So I'm like, okay, perfect.
And I don't notice it either.
Yeah.
I think you're kind of a perfectionist because you're the one like
I kind of know what's going on.
Now another thing I hear a lot, people wanting to know, is there a glitch in the app? Because I see the same dance every single day. So people did week one, and
it's
they
Groundhog
saw the same
Day.
Dance every day. And now they're in week two, and they're seeing that same dance from last week every day.
Mm-hmm.
But what you maybe haven't seen is if you scroll down, there's a new dance. So Emily, do you want to tell
us? Okay, yes.
Kind that of is not design. A glitch. That is not a glitch.
How the program is designed?
Yep.
So it's a 12-week program. So the idea is to kind of work on those. So we got week one, and you start off with a warm up, a dance, and a cool down. And then you have the optional
every day.
Tone and pump every day.
Every day.
And then you're gonna master those week one, and then week two, you unlock an additional dance. And then that allows you to challenge yourself that week. See all the fingers, we've got lots of things going here. But now, week two, we've mastered these.
Visual.
Everybody focus here.
These I've mastered.
You've mastered. But this guy
is new.
He's new. And you got to work on him.
With him a little bit.
But
don't
worry.
We're going to master him.
Bring him over, because week three.
There's a new guy that you got to master.
Is everyone with me still? Anyway, so each week we are adding on an additional dance, allowing you to get really, really good at those dances, and then just challenge yourself to do one additional dance each week. Then by the end, you are like the master of them all. You are killing it and getting even a better workout each week because you're repeating those dances and being able to put more energy, more strength,
and
you know, just push yourself a little bit harder rather than like thinking about every little move. You're like, oh, I know this one.
Yes. Feeling good.
You know, and we're not making you think about every single dance every single week anew, you know.
By design, which I love that about the program, because I will say, probably the biggest, so there's so much great feedback. Now, of the difficult feedback, it's people saying, oh my gosh, I watch them dance and I'm super intimidated by what's going on. I don't feel like that. I feel like it's too difficult for me.
Yeah.
And we're here to say that it is not too difficult for you. It is designed that way. That is one thing, like what she just talked about, the finger thing, right? You get.
Remember this?
Yes.
Remember
please,
this.
Remember that. That is designed so you can actually master and feel like a pro and know that it's not too hard of a program for you. So Emily, we're here with some tips today on how you can make the most and create success within the dance program. So Emily, if someone's looking at this and they're like, oh my gosh, I'm overwhelmed.
I can't dance. Yeah, I never danced.
I think I actually said it. So I was watching them the first time and I said, I don't have rhythm like you do. And what'd you say back to me?
I said, everyone has rhythm. It just looks different.
And
right?
I was like, oh, like that is the most amazing.
Right?
I never forgot it.
I think it's true. I mean, we don't all have to move the same, you know? And the thing is that we were talking about that as we repeat that, it becomes more and more intuitive and you will be amazed that you start catching on. Of course, at first, you're gonna be like, oh no, I cannot. You look at that and it looks like we're going crazy and there's no way that you're gonna catch on. Over time, and that's the beauty of repeating it, is that you get better and better and it's more and more familiar every single time.
Yes.
And you'll get it, absolutely. And no one's watching.
I love it, dance like nobody's watching.
Yep, no one's watching,
so. My dad always said, rule number 62, don't take yourself so damn seriously. And I swear, every time I look at this program, I think of that. Like you always say, just have fun.
That's right.
We're here to have fun, don't take yourself so seriously.
Now, totally, that was that whole mental game that I had too. It was like, well, I don't wanna look nerdy, you know, doing this move, but it's like, who cares, right? You're moving and you can do this.
Calories.
That's what I think is so cool too, is that you have the ability to dance. You have the ability to move and get working out and moving your body. So celebrate that. And it may look a little different than me, but you're moving and you're getting that workout in. So good for you.
And then another thing I want to point out that we talked about is consistency and patience. So it takes 10,000 hours of doing anything for you to actually become an expert. So nobody, not even she, was a master when she first started dancing, which is hard to believe.
Oh my, I'll find
practice
footage.
Practice makes perfect.
It's like practice makes progress.
That's another thing she taught me. Practice makes progress. And you know what? Like I can relate. When you had said, you know, you weren't like that always. It takes practice. It took me practice.
Oh yeah.
I felt that same way with even just on camera work. I was horrendous.
Just staring.
I know. I was like this. But then it's like you put enough hours into anything, and you really can become an expert.
100%. And consistency. I mean, consistency with anything, you become better and better at it. It becomes more and more familiar. But if you're gonna give up before you even start, there's no way that you're gonna get there, right? So keep at it and then be patient because—
The P word,
because you will get it. And it doesn't have to be perfect, you know? But it's gonna get easier and easier for you. You're gonna get better and better and you're gonna get sweatier and sweatier. And that's the goal, right?
That's what we want, yes. Now, there's one final tip that I want you to give. so people are like trying to follow along. I've heard you talking about this. What do they do? They're like, you're doing all this stuff, but I can't.
I call it chasing the beat.
Yeah. So you say,
you're like one step behind. Yeah,
yeah. That's me. I'm usually like two or three steps behind, though.
They're that way? Oh, wait, they're that way. Yeah.
Yeah.
It can be intimidating for sure, but one of the most important tips is there's a lot going on. So when you're looking at us, our arms are all over the place.
And
our feet are all over, and our hips are going crazy. But so start with just focusing on the footwork and focusing on what my feet are doing. Totally take your hands out of it and maybe take your hips out of it if you can, because they're hard to let go. And just focus on the feet. And then, you know, as we're repeating these week after week, if you feel, okay, now I've kind of got that. I know we're going two here, forward, back, whatever. Now I'm gonna add the arms to it. And that's okay, just build upon it. Start with the feet, then add the arms, and then add those hips.
So you go
boom.
Feet, arms, hips.
Head, shoulder, knees, or toes, I don't know. And then the hips, yeah.
And so when you
teach. I think
that
helps, simplifying the movement, you know.
And I know you were telling me, so I don't know if you guys know, but Emily actually teaches classes like in person multiple times a week.
I do.
And I love watching her teach. People just love her energy, love her class.
It's so fun.
And I know you tell them, you say, what is your rule?
Oh, yeah.
If they say, I didn't catch on day one.
Oh, very good, very good. I always say, come back. Because they always say, oh, that was crazy. This is not for me. And I say, you got to give it three times. You got to give it three times to really feel like, wait a second, because even in my classes, I'm repetitive and I bring routines back. And so they're like, wait, I remember that from last time I was here.
Yep.
So then they're feeling a little bit more comfortable, and then the same thing happens on the third time. Then they start really kind of understanding my body language, yeah. my nonverbal cues, right? Because we're pushing, I'm pointing this way or yes. I'm coming forward.
Yes.
And those things start to make sense to you. So three times.
Magic number three. So
give
if
it a
you
try.
Didn't like it day one.
That's right.
Try day two. It's kind of like when kids don't like foods. I always say it takes your palate five exposures before
really?
You actually can determine.
Is that a fact? Is that a scientific fact?
I heard it somewhere one time.
Yes,
so we're gonna
I
say
like
it's a fact.
That. I'm going to use that.
But if you think about it, you don't really know if you like food until your palate has adjusted to it. So your body doesn't really know if it likes dance until mm-hmm. you give it time to adjust to what it is that you're
100%.
Doing. Then make a decision. Commit to 3 days.
Yeah.
I love that. Commit
yeah.
to 1 week or 3 days and then make a decision.
I like the commit to the 1 week, really.
Yeah.
Because just give it, I mean, what do you got to lose, right? And here's the thing, you turn the music on,
yeah.
you feel happy immediately.
You do.
You know, that's just like something that boosts your mood immediately.
Yes.
I got a message, that reminds me. I got someone who messaged me this morning and she said, I did not feel like working out today. And so she wasn't gonna work out. And she was like, well, let me try that dance program. It's the first time.
No
she
way.
Tried the dance program and she was like, that was amazing. That
oh.
was so fun. She absolutely loved it. And so I thought that's the perfect story that you wanna hear because
yes.
this girl wasn't gonna work out. And then she gave the dance program a try. Now she's got a workout under her belt, and now
so
she's
cool.
excited to work out tomorrow.
See, and the key
so
of
works.
The whole program,
yeah.
like the whole reason we had you come in and you wanted to do this with us is because
yeah.
you and we wanted to help people work out without feeling like they were working out.
Exactly.
Just having fun.
Exactly. I mean, you always say this, that if you're not having fun, doing the workout that you're doing, then you're doing it wrong.
Yes.
Right?
Amen.
And we know that not everybody loves to dance necessarily,
yeah.
which really doesn't make sense to me,
yeah.
but but I've heard it once or twice, but I kind of feel like if you put music on in your home, it will lighten the mood immediately, even if that's not even your workout for the day.
Just put it
shake
on.
Shake it
watch
with me
dance.
For a few minutes. Watch me dance, yeah. And get
and
the family
you're
involved.
You're gonna have a hard time not wanting to like move a little
oh,
bit.
Oh yeah,
you know?
Before you know it, you're like, wait, what's
oh,
happening
oh,
here?
I can
my
do
feet
this.
Are
oh.
moving.
Yes. Twinkle toes.
And we'll just drag you in.
Oh,
or just it's like
cast
this.
Out a reel
yes.
And I'll reel you in. How
yes.
do you fish?
There's so much more to movement and dance than just the burning of the calories. It's
perfect.
It's just so good mentally
yes.
too.
I love it. So you guys, I hope this sheds a little more light on the dance program, the what, the why, the how,
oh, yeah.
to make and create success for you. We love you guys so much. Thanks for your support and your love. If you want anything else, have any questions, please comment below. We'll make sure she stays in the
come
community.
Dance, guys.
By the way, we have phase two coming out very
oh,
soon.
Yeah.
We're gonna keep going.
Come.
Bye, guys. Mwah.